Lead a one-man revolution from your armchair, talking cliches to listeners that aren't there. You call it warfare, but your wars aren't fair. If they were, they'd be suicide bombers in arms fairs.
YouTube salute. All right, Meek Mill talking about he's going to expose the major record labels about their slave deals they given to artists. Meek Mill hit Twitter Thursday, December 19th, and he voiced his frustration saying, what about major companies taking kids from the ghetto and got them signing their lives away for a little bit of money? We taking control of that 2020 and exposing the people offering these slave deals. I'm going to get some lawyers to break down some of these deals y'all offering these kids. He also said, I don't trust people and their motives really no more. Everybody planning to make something off you without you knowing. Record labels been exploiting rap artists for the longest. Meek Mill isn't the only person alone, because you also have Tory Lanez taking shots at Interscope Records, and he said he's threatened to expose them too. And I believe Tory Lanez jumped on his Instagram maybe like 2 or 3 days ago and went live and talked about that. So Meek Mill's been doing his thing, you know, even with speaking about the injustice and social issues. You know, Meek Mill has been, you know, trying to do a lot of things about the criminal justice reform. You know, so shout out to Meek Mill. This is my perspective. I commend Meek Mill for what he's doing. I think it's a great thing because it takes heart and will for artists to come out and talk about this. A lot of people don't want to talk about this. A lot of people just want to just be, no, shut up, be thankful. This is the same type of mentality when you have with the house Negro and the field Negro. Malcolm X said it best. The house Negro wants to be comfortable. He wants to stay in a position that he wants the master to like him. The field Negro wants to run away. He wants to be independent. He's tired of being oppressed. He's going to do anything he can for his freedom. I believe rappers today should be independent because there's more financial freedom there for them. Financial independency. There's so many things I feel. When you with a record label, it's hard to get your masters. There's so many artists in history. Think about it. Look at the locks, what happened with them with Bad Boy. They had to almost get into a physical altercation with Puff Daddy. Did he actually release their masters to them? Jay-Z went through a little situation with his first album, Reasonable Doubt, to get the masters. And Dame Dash was mad about that. You know, Dr. Dre, he left Death Row. He left Death Row and went to Aftermath. I mean, that was a success, but a lot of people don't make it like that. So I believe owning your own masters, going independent, you might not have that marketing brand behind you, like that big machine that's actually pushing you, but I still feel that being independent, it pays off in the long run. It's just like owning your own business or working for an employer. Yes, you're going to have your benefits. Yes, you're going to have your 401k, your medical, dental, and vision, all that's covered through an employer, but you're still making them rich and you're giving them generational wealth, whoever that CEO president is. But if you have your own business, you control everything. That's everything you can pass down. That's everything you can cover. Everybody doesn't have that entrepreneurship mindset. That mindset is not there. So it's hard for people to see that. But you have a lot of independent artists today. You think about Immortal Technique. You think about Vinnie Pies. You think about Dead Prez. You think about maybe Crooked Eye now. You think about artists in the UK like Akala, Bugsy Malone, Dirty Goods is another rapper. There's a lot of rappers right here that's independent. And they're actually making moves and doing their thing. And we salute them because that's the type of things we should be doing. And they go on tour, all that money's coming back to them. The label can always front you the money, but at the end of the day, they control you. And whatever you write, that's their rights now. You don't control your music. You become a slave to them. So let me know what y'all think about Meek Mill, y'all. I actually salute Meek Mill. I support him. I think this is a great thing, what he's doing. You know, some people are going to say, be safe, Meek Mill. They're going to try to assassinate you, the Illuminati, and this and this and this. But it is what it is. But post your comments below. Oh, smash Black Panther the like button, subscribe to my channel, click the bell icon to be notified when I upload new content and go live. If you'd like to support and donate to the channel, I have Venmo, Cash App, PayPal, Streamlabs, everything's in the description. Until next time, peace.